Meanwhile, Ukraine's defense minister says Russia is preparing a major offensive to mark the first year of the war. Oleksiy Reznikov says Moscow has recruited thousands of troops and is ramping up training for a potential attack on February 24th. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky has urged Western allies to speed up the delivery of new weapons for his country. He says the battle on the front lines in eastern Ukraine has become tougher ahead of the invasion anniversary. A Russian missile attack in the Ukrainian city of Kramatorsk leaves at least three people dead. Officials say Wednesday's missile strike destroyed an apartment building and damaged seven more in the city. Some 20 other civilians were injured. Ukraine has long accused Russian forces of targeting civilians in the war. Last month, at least 44 were killed when a Russian missile also hit an apartment building in the eastern city of Dnipro. Tensions flaring once more in the Gaza Strip. The Israeli military says it conducted airstrikes in the area Thursday after intercepting rocket fire. No word yet on possible casualties. Israel says the attack targeted weapon production sites used by the Islamist group Hamas. The fresh exchange of fire followed last week's loss of lives from both sides. 10 Palestinians were killed during a raid by Israeli forces, while seven were shot dead by a Palestinian gunman in Jerusalem. It also comes after the visit of U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken, who urged Israel and Palestine to de-escalate the tensions and work on resolving the conflict. Taipei scrambles fighter jets anew in response to new incursions by Beijing in the Taiwan Strait. Taipei's defense ministry says Chinese aircraft and ships were spotted off the strait Wednesday. It adds the Navy has been put on alert and missile systems have been activated due to the development. China's ramped up military and economic pressure on Taiwan in the previous years to force a self-ruled island to accept its claim. U.S. Defense Chief Austin also paid a courtesy call on President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in Malacanang. There, Manila and Washington again reaffirmed their strong alliance.
The future of the Philippines, and for that matter, the Asia Pacific, will always have to involve the United States, simply because those partnerships are so strong and so historically embedded in our common psyches that it can only be an advantage to both our countries.
We do have a strong relationship, and my goal, and certainly President Biden's goal, is to strengthen that relationship in every way possible. You are a key ally and an important ally, and so from the defense perspective, we will continue to work together with our great partners to build and modernize your capability as well as increase our interoperability.
Austin's visit follows a three-day trip by U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris to the Philippines in November, which included a stop on Palawan, the province closest to the South China Sea. There are no reports of casualties and missing individuals so far following the magnitude 6 tremor that hit the southern Philippines. Damage assessment is still ongoing in the Davao region, but at least two houses are totally destroyed. The quake struck Davao de Oro Wednesday night, forcing some residents to stay in temporary shelters and causing power interruptions. The U.S. says it would extend help to affected areas.
We were very sorry to learn yesterday that there was an earthquake down in Mindanao. We stand ready to help in any way that we can. I think our AID personnel are in the area, and they stand ready to help to provide humanitarian assistance when and where possible. So please don't hesitate to reach out if.